We're here at the CPJ Awards. The Committee to Protect Journalists is honoring three brave journalists from around the world, one from Ethiopia, one from Venezuela, another one from Russia, and a fourth journalist who could not be with us because he's in prison in Iran. This award ceremony is a reminder that press freedom is not a given. In many countries around the world where journalists face jail, harassment, threats, and attacks for doing their job. And at this event, over 900 people are attending, mostly media, leaders in media, the legal industry, and policymakers attending this event to really hear the stories of these four journalists, including one from Ethiopia named Dawit Kebede. Dawit Kebede runs the last independent political newspaper in Ethiopia. He spent 21 months in prison for writing an editorial that essentially criticized the Ethiopian government's following elections in that country in 2005. Mr. Dawit has continued to report and practice journalism from the capital, Addis Ababa, while most of his colleagues have fled into exile or left the country. As you know, many Ethiopians continue to leave the country because of a climate of fear and self-censorship. And Mr. Dawit tonight reminded the audience that the United States gives Ethiopia hundreds of millions of dollars in the fight against terrorism in the Horn of Africa. But Mr. Dawit made the point that this money is actually being used by the Ethiopian government to terrorize its own citizen, to block websites, to limit the news and information that they have access to. And Mr. Dawit shared with us his story, the story of just another committed and passionate journalist who is attempting to report the truth, but is being called an enemy of the state for reporting the truth or expressing an opinion that the leaders of Ethiopia do not agree with. So tonight we are inspired by one of ours, a journalist working from Addis Ababa, running a local newspaper who got the opportunity to speak to an audience of 900 people, leaders of media in America, and to remind them that they have a duty as journalists in this country to pay attention to what is happening around the world.
መልካም ይሄ እንግዲህ እኔ እንደሚታወቀው በምርጫ 97 ወቅት ህዝብን ለአመጽ በማነሳሳት በሚል ህገ መንግስቱን በኃይል ለማፍረስ በሚል ከተፈረደባቸው ከታሰሩ ጋዜጠኞች አንዱ ነኝ። እንግዲህ ከዛ በኋላ ብዙም የተለየ ነገር የለውም። የጻፍነው ነገር ሰዎች ለምን ተቃውሟቸው ሲገልጹ ለምን ይታሰራሉ ለምን ይገደላሉ የሚል ነበር። ከዛ በኋላ በተለያዩ ክስቶች በአገር ክህደት በጀኖሳይድ ክስ ተመሰረተብን። እንግዲህ ከዛ በኋላ ለ21 ወራት ያህል እስር ቤት አሳልፌያለሁ። ከእስር ቤት ከወጣሁ በኋላ በይቅርታ ነው የወጣሁት። እነዚህን ነገሮች ለተፈጸሙ ግድያዎችም ሆነ ለተፈጸሙ ጥፋቶች በአጠቃላይ እኔም ሆንኩ ሌሎች አብረውኝ የታሰሩ ሰዎች ኃላፊነቱን እንደምንወስድ ፈርመን የወጣ ነው። ፈርመን ከወጣን በኋላ እንግዲህ ሌሎቹ ስደትን መረጡ። እኔ ደግሞ በግሌ ምንም ጋዜጣውን በሀገር ውስጥ ምንም አይነት ጫና አይኖር ምንም ሆነ ምን ኢትዮጵያ ውስጥ መቀጠል አለብኝ የሚል አቋም ይዤ ያው ቀጠልኩኝ። እና አውራምባ ታይምስ ጋዜጣ ተመሰረተ በፌብሩዋሪ 2008 ላይ። ከዛ በኋላም እንግዲህ በአዲሱ ጋዜጣ ወደ 8 የሚጠጉ ክስቶች ተመሰርተውብኛል። እንግዲህ እስካሁን እየሰራው ነው፣ ጋዜጣው እስካሁን እየቀጠለ ነው። አሁን እንግዲህ ሲፒጄ እነዚህን ነገሮች ግምት ውስጥ አስገብቶ ተሸላሚ አድርጎ መርጦኛል። በጣም አመሰግናለሁ።
should all be very proud to present the 2010 International Press Freedom Award, Dawit Kebede.
Thank you. I accept this award on behalf of the staff of our weekly newspaper, Awramba Times, as well as the scores of Ethiopian journalists who have been jailed or forced into exile, as many others still struggling to make the press freedom promise and constitution a reality. It's a great honor for me to come to America, a country that receives millions of American taxpayer dollars to fight terrorism is all of Africa. But without anti-terrorism law, I risk 25 years in prison if I interview opposition politicians labeled as terrorists by the government. We cannot even access certain websites because they are blocked. Security officials regularly call our resource to question our editorial decisions. I have often wondered how it feels to be a journalist and report without constant fear of arrest. I wonder how it feels to express opinions without being labeled by members of the state or hounded by a criminal. I always wanted to be a journalist. I always wanted answers to the things I didn't understand and liked asking questions. In journalism school, I had a choice. I had the choice of an easy career in public relations or sports and entertainment reporting. But for me, having my own newspaper was the only way I could express myself. In 2005, Ethiopia saw its most contested election and protests followed. Because I wrote an editorial asking why almost 200 people lost their lives in the brutal regulation that was stupid. I was accused of treason and spent 21 months in prison. I drew strength from the resilience of prisoners on this show, from writings by some of you, including Ali Zakaria and Joe Clay. And hearing about international solidarity at the CPJ representative's visit in my prison, to get my freedom, I had to sign a statement accepting full responsibility for the election bias. After prison, my sister advised me to leave the country and do something else was my life. But I was already applying for a new newspaper license. Even obtaining a license was a struggle that I would only receive. The easiest thing for us would be to print government press releases, but that would make us also press. I am committed to continue to ask questions. I see this award as a message to those who benefit.
ሽልማቱ ምን ይፈጥራል ለሚለው ነገር እንግዲህ ሽልማቱ ምንም ጥያቄ የለውም በጣም ያበረታታ ነገር ነው የበለጠ ነገር እንድትሰራ የበለጠ መስዋዕትነት ለመክፈል የሚያነሳሳ ነው ለሌሎች ወዳጆቼ ሆኑ ጋዜጠኞች ጓደኞቼ ብርታትን የሚሰጥ ነው በነጻ ህሊና ሊዳኝ የሚችል ተመልካች ከጎናችን እንዳለ የሚያሳይ ነው በጣም ደስ ብሎኛል ግን ደግሞ ደስታ ብቻ ሳይሆን ትልቅ ኃላፊነትና ሸክም የሚጠይቅ ነገር ነው ምክንያቱም ከዚህ በኋላ ፕሮፌሽናል ነገሮችን ኮንሲደር አድርገን ብዙ ነገሮችን ለመስራት ብዙ ነገር እንደሚጠበቅብን የሚያሳይ ነገር ነው በጣም አመሰግናለሁ ስለሰጣችሁኝ እድል ይህ ሽልማት የግሌ ብቻ ሳይሆን በመላው ኢትዮጵያውያን ጋዜጠኞች ስደት ላይ ባሉት በአገር ውስጥ ባሉት ስም ነው የምቀበለው ታንክ ዩ